This is the full build for the full mechanics Gundam Raider from the Seed series. Okay, all the pieces have been removed from the runners and the nubs have all been cleaned off, so we're all set to start building. While building, I'm going to go ahead and apply these metallic stickers. Most of them are for the head. There is one for the arm weapon, and there are the eyes and the lenses and such like that. So those will go on as I'm building it. So let's just get right on into this. I am looking forward to building this. This is the first 1/100th scale model that I've built. So, and it wasn't that big of a deal to get the pieces cleaned up. This went much quicker than some of the smaller models I've worked with, because you're just working with such big pieces and stuff like that. So, this model starts with the arms and then kind of works its way around. So we'll go ahead and start with the right arm. There's a lot of duplication. Until you get to details on the orientation of the arm and the shoulders and stuff like that. It's pretty much the same pieces. So the common arm unit stuff is here, and then we'll do the right arm, and then we'll do the left arm. That's fairly typical for any model. A few little tiny pieces, but not too bad. Okay. Excuse me. Looks like this has to go on first. Here. Oh, it goes in here. Okay, so this is the movement for the, this must be the shoulder or the, where the arm connects to the body or the shoulder unit. Oh, no, yeah, this must be where it goes to the body. It just looks like it's a gun, a shoulder gun. That's cool. Thank you. forgot to put the barrel on. Now, go ahead and this goes up under here. This. Okay, this is slightly lower part. The higher part goes to the front. Well, considering that this part near the front. Okay. Interesting. Okay. And it's this, okay. Oh, nice, okay. Flaps here. Okay, oops. Be careful there. That'll support the just make sure that when you put these in, you're supporting the back. You know, the inside here, things are going to come apart or no longer connect as they should. There we go. Why isn't this working? Oh, I see. The only thing that moves is the gun. Okay. And then this. Okay, cool.
Cool. Okay. Seems to be the elbow. Okay, yeah, it says there's pits there. Barcodes on top. A little bit tight. Yeah. Another piece that is, and that is tight. Once everything's together, they move much better once you get leverage, but still quite tight. Okay, yeah, that's going to be the elbow joint. I might have put this on backwards. I think I did, that's why things aren't fitting quite right. You don't already have one, these are invaluable. Just a piece separator. Get any kind you want. They're incredibly helpful. There we are. Much, much better. There we go. Excellent. Okay. This one, very similar to the other piece, just they're slightly different. The one that went into the shoulder right here, very similar, but see. To make sure you're looking at the picture to make sure you're getting the right one in the right place. They probably won't fit in the same places. They'll only probably only fit in where it's supposed to go. Thank you. one. This is... this way. It's not setting it. Why isn't it? Well, I guess it's not supposed to. A bit difficult to get. This and that. Top part up. Okay. I guess that's what's gonna... There we go. Okay, that snapped in finally. Okay. Good to know that there's definitely a snap. This will hold it all together. Thank you. bulky, I guess. And we have the hand pieces here. Okay, cool. Looks like they've... Good. I recently built the SD, mesh-grade SD of the Freedom Gundam. And I was impressed in how they had found a way to allow these ball joint articulated fingers to stay together by using the back of the hand. So it looks like this might be something they introduced with earlier models and improved it greatly, because it has, it's not, this is just the thumb that's articulated. Whereas with the Master Grade SD, it is more like a real grade, like the old real grade hands used to be, that were a pain in the butt to work with, where you had the thumb, the index finger, and then the other three, but it uses the back of the hand to keep it together. So I'm glad that this does it here as well. And this is a gripping hand, so really all you need to have moving is the is the thumb anyway. Okay. And that goes in there. Okay. And we do this gear part here, which is this with this one out here. Yep. And then this goes here. And then this just fits in here. Oh, yep. Okay. And this just goes right here. Okay, this is what attaches it to the body, to the torso, for extra articulation, it looks like. That's cool. Huh. Interesting to see how that mechanism works and what it gains with all this. Huh. Okay. There's one arm. Let's go ahead and do the second one.
Thank you.
face here. This one through here. This one underneath. This. This one. This snaps in there. This pulls up so that this can come out. It's tighter. Ouch. This one's so much tighter. Okay. There we go. Okay. Doing the left arm. So this is where some of the pieces are going to be oriented slightly differently, so just be sure to look at the pictures, because the placement will matter. Thank you. like snap that time. Sure, I'm putting it on right as far as the bend of the elbow. Oops. Which it didn't do in the other one. What's going on here? As far as that one is, it is. I guess it is. Okay. There. Okay, there we go. Just had to get the shoulder joint in place properly. I guess after all that, the only difference is the way that this is turned. Okay. So we've got this. Okay, there's our two arms. And now the chest.
sure I didn't miss any decal applications, and I didn't. You can always tell if there's deep. The nice thing about the larger kits is they break down the instruction symbols that they do it on each page where it applies. So if there's a sticker on that page, it shows you right here at the bottom that there's a sticker. So you don't have to just be looking for, you know, this little turned up piece of paper image. It tells you here that, oh, you got stickers on this page. So that's always helpful. Okay. Starting with, okay, we've got, that looks like it's this, and this, oh, I see, okay, yep, it goes on, there's a little slot that, this little part in here, it'll only go in one way, so there's a slot to accommodate and restrict the movement to accommodate the raised part in here. Oh, I see. I didn't realize that was in a circle. Take this. Okay, I guess that fits. It's supposed to fit right in there. No. Oh wait, I think this is supposed to go. It's supposed to go like that. Oh, I guess. Yeah, it does. Okay. It's supposed to fit in this little slot here. That's going to be some new that's going to be some mechanism somewhere for articulation. I think it's going down though. There it is, slid down. Okay, next to this, so I guess. This goes to the top. Okay, there's something that clips into that. Oh no, I guess. They can fit the parts as far as they will go. See, it is supposed to push up, isn't it? Thank you.
supposed to just sit out here like this. Or something there. So these slots, I don't understand. Nothing for them to slot into. Am I missing something? All the way down. Okay, it does have that right there, so... Okay. There we go, that's problemless. This part wasn't pushed down enough. Okay, and then that will let me support something eventually. Okay. These things here. Oh, okay, I guess that pushed up. Yeah, that's an interesting... This piece is coming apart here. Until whatever clips on there is in place. See. Ah. This clips in there. Okay, come on, okay. Oh, okay. Interesting. Now that won't fall out because it's clipped in. I would assume this just feels so loose. There's something not right here. There we go, that wasn't clipped in. Okay, much better. Nice, very nice. I like that. Okay. Okay, so it's this. Yep. Okay, this is for the head, because this is a typical neck
collar. Guess I don't need to say neck collar, do I?
This is supposed to go there.
Now, one thing to keep in mind with this mobile suit is it does transform into a mobile armor. So probably a lot of this, these gimmicks that are being put in place right now while we're building it, are to facilitate that. It's this instead, that's why. This whole thing goes into here.
Okay.
Ouch, it's sharp. One thing I've noticed with the non-HG kits that I put together, and that maybe it's just because HG is considered to be a beginner grade, or I don't know, but I've noticed that they'll use a single image to indicate something that has to happen, like in this case. This part right down here, that there, has to go into here and get caught and be underneath in order, because it's got a slide mechanism here, which once again is probably for the transformation to the mobile armor. But in an HG kit, it would have showed this underneath the piece and all that kind of stuff, or at least the earlier HG kits that I put together. Or actually, even the Witch from Mercury ones do. So, I honestly think it's because the HGs are considered for beginners. And if you're doing a master grade or a full mechanics or a real grade, they feel that you don't need as much instruction. Because you have more experience. So I guess that goes there. Okay. Huh. Okay. So. And then this all gets set down into here now. Whoop. Else on here so that everything's locked in and see what this thing does. And then we've got this. Okay, we got everything locked in now. Okay, so we got the torso. Okay. Oops. Uh-oh. Ah, damn it. This just go right on. This, yes. I'll get something else to hold out of this. Okay. Oh, okay, and that's what pushes into. Okay, cool. This is where most of the stickers are going to go on. I am just going to be using the stickers because these stickers are either going to be behind other things, like they go on to the eyes here and then they're underneath other pieces, or they're going to be recessed so the edges aren't going to show.
the mask on first. Seems kind of strange to have green metallic stickers when the green plastic underneath. I might just keep it that way. It just seems strange. I think the plastic's gonna look much better without all the other stuff on it. There. This goes like this so that the chin can pop out. Oh, come on. Seated there. And then this goes on. There we go. Much better. That's the back of the head. This here is for that. This. Just like this on top here. Yeah, I think that looks fine. In fact, I think it definitely looks better than any stickers would look. Nice little detail of the red poking through the cheeks. That's interesting. Okay, so this will just move right back, right? Yes. And this goes on top to hold them in place. And then this is interesting. kind of, instead of putting the head together and just popping it on, you actually, you actually finish constructing the head around the neck ball joint. This goes in there. Yeah, there we go. Pretty good head movement. Trying to turn all the way around, not quite. Arm gets in the way, but that's okay. I will put the sticker. Right there because it's just black. So. Okay, on my precision cotton swabs here and just get that right in there. Okay, cool. And then the arms get put on. Okay, so this is supposed to point down. As this will go. Oh, I see. Oops. Okay, cool. And we've got the upper body done. Neat. Put these aside for right now. I may decide to go, I got one that I need for the other one, but I may decide to put those on the head later on. Have to just see. Okay, time for legs. And just like with the arms, many of the pieces are duplicated within the legs until you get to the articulation part, where it just depends on which way the joints bend. That's this goes there. Oh, okay, this is the ankle. That's the ankle joint. This.
Like there's any articulation in the foot. It's all just solid mass, except for, you know, the ankle itself. But then this is a full mechanic, so it's supposed to be master grade light. So, there you go. This has to slide in front to back to front, not up.
Like this. Yes, it does. Oh, I'm wrong. No, this is just the toes. This is the heels over here. There is some articulation in the foot. That much. Okay, that made it much easier. Yeah, you got your typical front of foot heel movement. Not bad. This goes like this. At first, this. Okay, so we got this, which is like that. Like that. Like this. So here's the knee joint. Lots of black out plastic here. Oh, I see. These have to go in. That has to go in there. Make everything want to. Okay. Oops. Step ahead. Down. Interesting. Why would they have that detail on it if it doesn't never shows? Maybe it shows in the transformation. Thank you. is this. There we go. Gotta get in the right groove. Okay. Those have to. Okay. Okay, that's just something to set aside for right now. Okay, so. Snap in, so I don't know how to see it properly. See enough. Okay, there we go. It's down. That's in. Okay. Oh, there's this one. Here goes in there now. Put this in the front. That's okay. That's interesting. There. Oh, no, it's not the stack. Set right there for right now. That when this comes along, we'll snap everything in. Okay. Okay, there's a leg. I have all these extra pieces. Another thruster that goes in the side.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Okay. any nubs I missed. Since everything is black, it's difficult to see the details on where things are supposed to fit in. There we go. Finally. Okay. Good, 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 good. Alrighty. A couple of tabs and slots here at the back of the toes that had to be set right. Okay. You would think the second leg would be easier. Thank you. extra one piece, that's why. Okay, nice loud snap. Okay, and this, and this. Let's see here. Yeah, guess it is what it is. Okay. Oh, I'm looking at the wrong. You have the right leg instructions. this goes kind of sitting here. And this goes on, locks it all together. Thank you. interesting. Okay.
We got our two legs now. Okay, we'll move on to the waist now. Like most Seed mobile suits, the waist is much more complex than other suits from other anime, where it's quite a bit more than just the skirts. That's why there's so many pieces. Gotta keep the smaller ones separate so I don't lose them. Okay. Yeah, see, there's all these gimmick points, like these side claws and such, so... With the front skirts, you can put them in so that they move together, or you can do what I'm going to do and separate them so they move individually by just basically cutting the little plastic part out from between the two balls.
since this seemed to be quite soft and it probably would have come off on its own. And now they're just going to move independently from each other. Which is much, much nicer, especially for the leg articulation and stuff like that. There we go. We got the individually moving skirts, so that's cool. Had that in my ear. I'm testing the audio. That's where these little guys come in. They can only go in one way, so you just kind of twist them until they push in. So that's good. Must be the side skirts, or maybe actually even the back. See here. This. Okay. Thank you. It's an angled piece, so there must be a specific... I see. Thank you. There's some other mechanism to hold this stuff all together. This is awfully loose. You know what, this probably pushes down. That's why you're going in from the bottom. This pushes down. How did it go? Pushed, okay. Flat piece of this that has to point down. How does that happen? No, I'm sorry, it points up. It's looking at the picture wrong. I had it right. Okay. These are the back skirts. Thank you. It's tight in here. Another case where just there's very subtle indications of what you need to do in the image. Make sure that this peg is out of the way, pointing to the side. That's why I couldn't get the other one on, because it was in the way. And the picture shows that, but doesn't have any kind of close-up or anything like you would get in other kits. Okay, I guess, yes. Okay. Use that part. So... Okay, cool. See everything lined up, it's fine. Okay, there's four of those. And this. Goes there, okay. It's a nice design. You just hook it on here and then just push it in. That was super easy. Okay. This. Here, so this goes on to here. And then the face away from that. Okay. Okay. On the side. This is where the side skirt patches, okay. That's where those pegs go in, it's here. Holds that right in place, so that's cool. I mean, everything just fits beautifully together there. Waste. Looks like I got it backwards in there. Oh, great. Let me take this part first. Interesting. Okay, and everything goes together. These out of the way. Which is the front? This is the front. Knees face them. Oh yeah, because they come out like that. Yes, they face the back. That's cool. Thank you. Okay, those are awfully loose. Upside down. There we go. Now let's move at least up and down. It was all the way through. Have to glue this on and sacrifice a little bit of the tilt. That thing's going to get way in the way of the torso. Okay, and then this goes on here. a beefy. For now, maybe that's more the way it's supposed to be, is down. Oh, I see. Yeah, that's... I feel like there's something missing right here. Looks like there's a clip there. Got nothing to go in it. Oh, probably it's part of the transformation. Okay. Quite a bulky, good size kit. Okay, now it's time to tackle the backpack. It's going to be with a little bit of yellow highlight, mainly black and red. With some dark gray inner frame type of workings. Okay. Fits right in there. That's interesting. Okay. And then push it in there. Got this and this. This goes into, oh, it's another little hidden gun. That's neat. Oh, I see. This must lift up. reveal the gun. That's pretty cool. This was... It's definitely where that piece goes, but
there we go.
Snaps in. And this goes right on here. This part goes on. Lots of pegs to line up. See, those just slot into there. There's a little bit of a gimmick mechanism there. Make sure I get the correct side. There we go. Okay. bring it up, not out. Okay.
Okay. Talking about the panel, I thought that was a panel line, so I had panel lined it. But it turns out to be buried. It's just the clip. Big bulky. This has one of those tab lock type things. This little tab right, let's see if I can get the right angle there. Little tab right there. Camera's not focusing on it though. Let's see here. There you go, there's a little tab there. There's that little tab, and in here, there is a slot right there. You gotta make sure that that's lined up to push it in, and then you turn it and it locks it in place so that's not coming off. Okay. So thank you.
not separate. Oh. Is that those there?
And this right here is the adapter for the stand. So what happens is the stand actually attaches to the backpack, and then the backpack attaches to the mobile suit, and that's how it gets on the stand. Thank you. does have twists at the back.
Okay.
I'm sure the backpack plays a major role in the transformation.
Cool. Aside for right now, now it's time for the weapons.
And this has a really cool mace mechanism. That's what this little wire's for.
There. Okay, there's a flat side. We can only go in one way. Okay, number one. Let's get the second one together. This holds the two together. Oh, that's pointing down.
Okay.
This. That's where one of the decals goes. Okay, that's that. Of course, they named the mace, actually they're saying it's a hammer, therefore, of course, they named it Mjolnir. Mjolnir. Thor's hammer. So what you need to do in this cable is make a knot on one end. Because this is going to be retractable. Manually retractable. Try and make it as tight as possible. Thank you. that's going anywhere. So essentially, these two pieces together form a way to close this together. On the spool. This. Oh, I didn't even notice that little hole right there. It's like a gun. Okay. So this goes through here. And that sets there. Comes together here.
The nice thing about this is, for the most part, it's interchangeable. Nope, wrong. There's only one way it'll fit. That's good. Okay.
And then you can just turn this and retract. Cool. And this goes on here. There's a slot that this, there's a tab that this, that you can only go on one way, so just turn it until you can get it on there. This goes on first. Then this has a little kink right in here. There you go. There's a little kink there that you need to work the wire around, and that locks it into the handle. Cool. And then this just covers it up. And then there's a different working hand. So the way the hands work on this, instead of taking the backing off, and such. Instead of having multiple hands, they just have multiple fingers. You just pop the fingers off, and if you want the trigger fingers, you just throw them in there instead. Angle it correctly. So this can either go on the arm right here, just be part of the arm, or this piece can come down and it can be held by the some backwards. No, there's no way I could have. Okay, it just looks awkward, that's all. It just looks different. Oh, I see. There's a the fingers right there have a couple of, see if we can get it in there. Right in there, can't see it because of the colors, but there's some slot, there's a couple pegs in there that fit right into the gun handle. Right there, those little indentations there, not on the back, but on this part. Right there. And they fit right in there so it holds it. Just gotta get the angle right. Hold on to that right like that. You can have it done just like that. And this is the hand that would hold the handle. Done from the inside. There we go. You hold on to it with the fingers wrapped around the inside, which makes sense. And then you have this that you can bring out, and it has an extra stand. It does have a stand, but for only this. How would that fit in? Something. Interesting. Interesting little detail, but that gives. Looks like that's now what this goes into. Yep.
So we've got a regular stand, just a little tiny accessory stand here for it. Oops. So that you can have this extended out and put. Because this wire will never really be strong enough to hold on to it. It's just there for effect. Alrighty. Now one thing I have decided to do is I will be putting the decals on the head, which I didn't do before. Because I'm realizing now that everything is encased, I'm not seeing, you don't get the nice little, glowing that I got before I attached everything on the head with the green piece. Which is probably why they gave stickers in the first place. Because I knew that once everything was together, that would happen. So, just keep in mind, if you need to take the head off, it's not just a ball joint holding it on. It actually, the back piece of the head had to let's just get these on. See, I mean, it without everything around it, it looks great. But then once everything's, the light can no longer go through it, it can't. Doesn't show very well. I'm surprised they didn't have us put this on before putting the mask on. But
is pretty recessed anyway, so it's not going to show bad once it's put together. Much better once everything's together. We'll have the glow that we expect from the lenses, essentially. It is crooked. Much better. Yeah, that looks much better. You can now see the eyes pretty well. The eyes and the lens right there. There we go. Much better. Let's go ahead and retract this. Okay. It's got a lot going on, but it actually looks pretty cool now that it's all put together. Okay, well that does the build. Not bad. Not bad at all. So, thank you very much for watching, and I will see you for the next one. Thank you for watching this video right to the end. If you did enjoy it, please do give it a thumbs up. That does help out the channel. If you would like notifications as to when new videos are posted to this channel, please do subscribe and hit that notification bell. If you do have time, please do enjoy one of the videos that are popping up around my head.